So welcome guys again, and today our topic is osmotic fragility test. Before going to topic, we have to understand some terms to understand this topic. So first is solution. Solution is made up of two things, solute plus solvent. Solute is always less in number, while solvent is always increase in amount. As you see, the particles is salt particles, we can say. So it is a solute and the solvent is in liquid form, so it is higher in number. Osmosis, it is a process by which molecule of solvent tend to pass through a semi-permeable membrane from less concentrated solution into more concentrated solution. So this is a beaker and having a semi-permeable membrane. This semi-permeable membrane having a capacity to pass out or pass in a selective particles or selective salt particles. So this area having a very less amount of solute, or we can say there is no any solute, while this part having a salt molecule very increase in number. So here we have a less concentrated and this is a more concentrated, and the osmosis if occur through semi-permeable membrane, so solvent tend to pass from less to higher concentration. So water will move, you can see this picture, water will move from less concentration to higher one. Okay, that's why you can see the change in the picture. So this is very very important and base of osmotic fragility test. Now inside the blood vessel or in the body, we have a similar concentration in the blood and inside the RBC of salt. Otherwise, if change in increase and decrease in concentration of salt inside or outside the RBC, it is directly harmful for the RBC. So isotonic solution, a solution having a 0.9 gram of NaCl in 100 ml. So what do you mean by isotonic solution? Nothing but it's similar to our body fluid. Okay, the concentration is similar to as like our body fluid. So you can see by this example, we have a 4 molecule of solute. For the example, I am telling you, and inside the RBC, we have a similar number of solute. That's why there is no any harmful for the RBC. While if we increase the concentration 0.9 to 1 gram, then 2 gram or 3 gram, it will become a hypertonic solution, a solution which having a very high amount of solute. So hypertonic or hypotonic basically depend upon the particle of solute. If the solute is higher, it is called as hypertonic, because hyper meaning is also a increase. So I already told you, when osmosis occur, water will move less concentration to higher concentration. That's why water will move from RBC into the beaker. In case of hypotonic solution having a low solute, as you see in the picture, but the solute inside the RBC were very high as comparison to them. So water will move low concentration into higher concentration. Okay. And finally, it lead to hemolysis, or we can say swelling of RBC leads to burst. The topic start from here. Osmotic fragility test. To measure the flexibility of RBC or capacity of RBC to check how much amount of RBC take water in decreasing concentration of solution. So what is this decreasing concentration solution? 0.9 is our isotonic solution, and if we decrease the concentration, let's suppose 0.8 gram, 0.7 gram, 0.5 gram, so this is a decreasing concentration, and we check or challenge the RBC in the different decreasing concentration of hypotonic solution. In the healthy body, RBC are biconcave. Okay, as I already told you in some video, the RBC are biconcave. While in disease state, hereditary spherocytosis, RBC are spherical in shape. So there is a disease called hereditary spherocytosis. As name suggests, spherocytosis, it means RBC are in sphere. So what happened between both of them? If we put both the RBC in the hypotonic solution, so this spherical RBC in hypotonic solution, a solution which having a less concentration, so water will move less concentration to higher concentration through semi-permeable membrane of RBC, and the water will enter, it will burst more quickly. Already RBC are spherical in shape and it cannot change their size much more. While in case of normal RBC, this is the biconcave RBC, if the water will move inside the RBC, it can change shape to somewhat spherical. It will also lies, but it takes some time as comparison with spherical RBC. So this is a thing we have to measure by this osmotic fragility test, whether the patient is a normal or hereditary spherocytosis, or in case of thalassemia also we check this. So principle is that small volume of blood is mixed with large volume of saline in different concentration. Finally, we check the hemolysis by spectrophotometer at 540 nanometer. We can change the volume, but not a ratio. Ratio should be 1:1000. One part blood and the more part is our NS, normal saline. Requirement, we have to take buffered normal saline so that pH maintained at 7.4. Saline is 0.9 gram per deciliter. Approximately we say 10 gram per deciliter to easy calculation. So if we make dilution of 0.9 gram of normal saline, like 0.9 in the original, then 0.8, 0.75, 0.6 and so on up to 12 dilution. Now we have to take a heparinized blood 2 to 3 ml. We cannot take EDT or other citrate, oxalate, because it containing a salt and it may affect the other. And it also seen that the inside the EDTA, while if you do osmotic fragility test, we see the increasing of fragile of our normal RBC. In a procedure, two sets of 12 tubes we kept in a rack, one set for test, another set for control. Take 2 to 2 ml of different dilution in saline. So thus the dilution we make a 0.9, 0.8, we have to take 2 ml of this, 2 ml of this in two sets of our tube. Okay, then add 20 microliter of blood in each dilution. And the dilution become a 1:1000 because 1 ml having a 1000 microliter. So automatically the dilution become 1:1000. We have to mix it and leave it for 30 minutes in room temperature. After the centrifuge at 3000 rpm for 10 minutes. Now measure the supernatant of each concentration at 540 nanometer. So HB released from the hemolyzed RBC absorb the light from spectrophotometer. So we have to keep in mind that our original sample should not be hemolyzed because it give a negative result to us. Okay. After that, we have to take a reading, and the reading is plot on a graph paper for test and control in a similar paper. Comparison test and control reading before final result of test. So this is very important chart. Please keep in mind how to take reading. Before taking reading, I am telling something that we have to take a reading at 50% lysis. It means we have to check the lysis at the 50% lysis at this range. Okay. So in the normal condition, the average is 0.5 to 0.04 gram per deciliter. While you can see instead of 0.5 gram, here we see 5. Instead of 0.04 gram, we have a 4.5. So this is because we have a NaCl concentration in this, according to this chart, is gram per liter. While previously I told you we are taking as it 0.9 by 100 ml. Okay, 0.9 gram NaCl in 100 ml. If you put this point and you can see the 9 by 1000. So we take 9 gram of RBC for 1000 ml of our water or distilled water to make like this. So this is just because of changing a unit deciliter to liter, but the whole phenomenon is similar. In a normal person, we can say that the 0.5 to 0.045 gram should be range for normal hemolysis. So you can see in the osmotic fragility test, 50% lysis at 0.5 to 4.5, it means 0.5 to 0.45. okay, while you can see in the spherocytosis, RBC of 50% little bit earlier than the our normal RBC. This is because this RBC of the spherocyte is already spherical shape and it cannot take further water, but the biconcave RBC can take. So that's why they can more retain in the 50% lysis. Okay, 9 is our isotonic solution, that's why there is no any lysis for patient or a normal. In 0.1% concentration, very very low hypertonic condition, okay, it means RBC lysis is 100%. Now osmotic fragility affected by shape, volume and surface area. As I already told you about the shape, the RBC, if the biconcave shape, they can take more water. Okay, and in case of volume, spherocytosis volume is already a bigger one than the normal RBC, so it will also affect. And surface area is very very important. The biconcave RBC having a more surface area because it can stretch more up to the spherical. So the thing you can understand with this, in the spherocytosis we have a low surface area, and if low surface area increase in fragility, What do you mean by the increase in fragility? It means if the low surface area of our spherocytosis, so it will more fragile in the hypotonic solution as comparison to our biconcave RBC. So temperature is also very very important thing, because we are doing osmotic fragility by two methods. One is fresh blood method, another is incubate our blood sample with the solution, our NS, for 24 hours after take a reading. And the lysis start for the incubated is 7, while the lysis initiate for the reference blood in case of healthy condition, okay, 5. And complete lysis according to, you can understand very well. What I am telling you from this chart, you can see the temperature also affect the reading. Okay, in the fresh RBC, you can see the hemolysis start at 5, because the RBC are younger one. While if we store the RBC, some RBC will take their 120 days and therefore it will be starting swelling very earlier hypotonic condition, and that is 7. So this is the difference how incubation affected. And the same phenomenon is for old sample or old RBC. If the old RBC kept in the refrigerator in case, so RBC become old. So we have seen less younger RBC as comparison to fresh blood. Then test should be done in between 2 hours of collection. This is also like that, all the thing is similar to each other. If we done a test after 2 hours or 4 hours, so we see the less amount of younger RBC, because some of RBC attain their 120 days. So it will also affect the RBC, our osmotic fragility. While the avoid hemolysis is also very very important, avoid needle which is very pointed, and do not vigorously mix the blood with anticoagulant. It will also cause hemolysis and affect our osmotic fragility test, because already I told you that the HB released from the RBC will absorb the light and give a reading to us, which we plot in our chart. Next one is change tip of pipette during dilution. So we have to, during a making of a dilution from 0.9 to 0.8, 0.8 to 0.75, like that, so we have to change the tip, otherwise there is an error in the dilution, okay, because more concentration is going to a, so this is a serial so this is a dilution error, so we should avoid it. And this is very very important topic. So here the topic is finished. And one question for you, if you listen very, very carefully, in which anticoagulant we take blood for osmotic fragility test? So this is your question.